electricity crowd here at the United Center, bringing you another edition of the NBA on 2K Sports. Alongside Greg Anthony and Steve Smith, with David Aldridge on the sideline, this is Kevin Harlan. And Julius Randle out with the injury, as he'll be missed.
Yeah, and as bad as it turned out to be, it tells you a little bit about his toughness, that when they took him to the locker room after he got hurt, he wanted to come back out and get back on the court.
He's the definition of a gamer. He doesn't want anything to slow him down, even an injury like that.
Here are the starters for Los Angeles. Caldwell Pope is the two, with Ingram playing small forward. Ivica Zubac is out there with Ibaka, and it's Thomas in at the one spot. Lakers on D. They couldn't put the pieces together, losing that last matchup with Boston.
A long and tiring game, made worse, obviously, by the fact they ended up in the second overtime falling short, which can be a real morale killer.
Now here's Ingram. He had a 15-point outing in their last game against Boston. Lays it up, and in spite of the excellent defense at that.
You think back when Fred Hoiberg was a player in the NBA, great shooter, who had a strong knowledge of the game. Not too surprised he ended up as a coach.
How on earth did they let him get that wide open?
Outside Thomas. The feed to Ingram. And so he earns a trip to the line. Officials saw the contact, and he'll shoot two. And Brandon Ingram, the second overall pick in 2016 out of Duke. What do you make of his rookie season?
You know, very much a work in progress. You have to remember how young he is. Didn't turn 19 until 3 months before the draft. And he's still a real fit. So he's got a chance to improve very quickly over the next few seasons as his body continues to mature.
He has really no ceiling on Ingram. This is a guy who has the potential to be a truly great player before it's all done.
And here is Los Angeles now. Here's Thomas. Good for the basket. Starting off 1-for-1 with that shot.
Yeah, good awareness there. He sees an opening and doesn't hesitate. A lot of laziness going on out there. Still early in the game, but that needs to get worked out.
Here's Mwamba, stolen by Zubac. A well called with a wide open look. And out of bounds as the Bulls gain possession. There's a break in the action, so a rundown now. The most reliable power forwards and centers over the past month when it comes to shooting the basketball. Lauri Markkanen in third.
And it's one thing to be able to create high-quality shots for yourself, but you still have to finish. And there's no doubt all those guys can do both.
Every one of them possesses a great touch around the basket. When they receive the ball in good position in the paint, it is just about automatic.
And setting the tone early with a strong move to the rack.
First quarter, you're really testing the defense, trying to find their weaknesses.
Now, here's Zubac. Pass to Ibaka. Nice ball movement here by the Lakers. Screen by Ibaka. Ingram kicks to Ibaka. And again, it's the Lakers.
Wow, that was a nice athletic roll out of the screen. Ibaka moves with tremendous ease.
Here's Dunn. And that one clearly a foul. Gets the whistle, and Zubac coming up. And Steve, mental fatigue is an issue that can play a factor when the season is in full swing. Is it more on the coach or on the player to keep the team focused on their goal?
I think the organization. I think the teammates, the coaches, whoever it is, to keep their camaraderie going. But ultimately, it comes down to the player. You have that responsibility. The coach can coach you up, but you got to find a way to get out of those ruts.
You see where it ultimately would come down to the player.
Yes, totally agree.
In a moment now to see some numbers for Ingram. He's averaging 11 points a game, 4 rebounds, and 3 assists. And guys, he's making winning plays. It's as simple as that. Not a star player per se, but he makes his presence felt.
And the numbers, they back it up. Whether he can sustain this level of production, we don't know. But the arrow's pointing upward right now. Excellent play call there. The defense was not prepared for the pick, and as a result, they gave up the wide open look.
And Markkanen with the basket on the assist from Dunn. 6 points for Lauri Markkanen.
And Markkanen continuing to improve inside. I mean, utilizing matching up with somebody with his skill set.
So Chicago going with an almost entirely new grouping. Portis, he's checked in for Lopez. Noah Vonleh comes in for Markkanen. Justin Holliday's checked in for David Mava. And it's Jaren Grant in for Dunn. And there's the foul. It'll go on Jaren Grant. That is his first foul of the game. Ball with a wide open look. A three-pointer is right on target. Ball's got himself on the board with 3 there.
I tell you, it's unorthodox to watch, but Ball shoots the ball with tremendous rhythm and confidence, and he has been deadly from beyond.
Here's Hart, and again, Los Angeles with the triple.
Their third three-pointer in a row.
151 left in the first quarter. Here's Vonleh. It's hauled in by Los Angeles. Last time they met was in Los Angeles.
It wasn't even close in their last matchup. And their offense just wasn't ready to compete at that level.
And for Serge nowadays, most of his offense comes from beyond the arc or at the rim.
Grant the pass to Portis. 122 left here in the opening quarter.
Can't finish. And defensively, nice job of altering the shot without fouling. Well, this Bulls team, the definition of mediocre last season, finished a 41-41 record. They decided it was time to trade away Jimmy Butler and go young.
Here's Vonleh, following the basket by Lonzo Ball. And he chants it with authority.
And no doubt they'd love to see him get a lot more of those opportunities.
And that deficit will go away quickly if he does break. Here's Kuzma. He hasn't scored yet. That I'm sure will change. Shots good by Ibaka. And for the Bulls, some felt they didn't get enough back in return for Jimmy Butler from Minnesota. Smitty, what's your take on that?
Well, the Bulls got younger. They got some shooting, which they really needed. Ask me in a few years after we see how these young fellas develop.
Outside Holiday lets it go from deep. Kuzma pulls it in. Lakers leading by 10. Now 8 seconds separate the two clocks. In the corner, Ibaka with it. There's the pick. Ball, the pass to Kuzma. And again, Los Angeles with the triple.
Timely passing leads to assists, and that's been the recipe for success.
Outside Holiday. Portis, nice persistence to tip it back up and in.
You have to box him out or he's going to beat you to the glass on both sides of the floor.
For 3, the shot will not fall. And so it's Los Angeles holding on to an 11-point cushion as we get ready to take a break. They're pounding the ball inside, and that's where they've gotten their best production tonight. Don't go anywhere. We'll be right back. Leading by 11. In a moment now to reset the lineups, courtesy of Gatorade, all fueled up for the second quarter of basketball. So for the Lakers right now, all out there with Hart. Then there's Mo Harkless. Then there's C.J. Miles. And it's Kuzma at the 5 down low. Holiday dishes to Valentine. Vonleh kicks to Valentine. To the middle. And Vonleh, the bucket on the assist by Valentine. Vonleh's got it back down to single digits for the Bulls. L.A.'s on 4 of 8 tonight for three-point land, shooting 50% on the free ball here. Pass to Kuzma. Lays it up off the glass. Kuzma's got his second basket of the night.
Haven't we seen that a few times today, guys? I mean, their defense has got to have a little bit more toughness about it.
second quarter with a little over a minute gone. Grant kicks to Portis. And he takes it in for the layup off a very nice feed. Portis has got six.
And they keep hammering away at him inside, forcing the ball into the paint.
Ball, the pass to Kuzma. And he got the whistle, so he'll have a three-point play opportunity.
And he takes full advantage, bumps up the lead. Yeah, the lead now is double digits. Some tricky matchups out there, not a lot of solutions.
Catching up on the changes for Chicago. Robin Lopez is checked in for Bobby Portis. Markkanen comes in for Noah Vonleh. David Wabon is checked in for Denzel Valentine. And it's done in for Jaren Grant. Six on the shot clock. Here's Mwaba, and it's going to be out of bounds. The Bulls really change possession. Los Angeles making a switch here. Ingram's checked in, and the first timeout of the game called for Chicago. They're coming off that win against Philadelphia.
And sometimes in a hostile environment, it is hard to stay true to who you are. But give them credit, they did, especially on offense.
Well, they came in with a strong game plan, made adjustments when they needed to, and kept the crowd out of their heads.
Kicks to Thomas. Wide open shot is on the money. Thomas got the lead up to 13 now for Los Angeles.
I mean, if you're looking to get back into this game, you have to get tougher defensively.
Here's Markkanen. And so he draws the foul on the shot. A trip to the line to shoot two. Many teams these days looking to play in transition. Some have suggested widening the definition of the clear path foul to allow those exciting situations to play out. What do you think?
No, I don't think so. I think it's still basketball defensively. I think if you have a guy that's out in front of you, I think the rules right now is fantastic. I don't want to see a change where guys are scared to make a play on the basketball because, hey, if I don't foul him, he gets a chance to get a bucket and two more shots. At the end of the game, in a huge game, which they all are, sometimes you want to be able to foul a guy, but if he's in front of you, I like the way the rules are right now.
Dunn kicks to Lopez. And again, Chicago. No good. Lakers leading by 14. And the pass to Harkless. They set the pick. He feeds it to Ingram. Outside Thomas. Again, the Lakers.
And the point differential tells the story. Their two-way play has been outstanding.
You know, it's a matter of effort plus talent. You need both to dominate this way.
Lopez. And the dunk by Lopez.
When Lopez gets in that close, it's tough to stop him from slamming it home.
It's Ingram on the wing. Passes it to Zubac. Back to Ingram. Takes the 13-footer and off the front iron, and in it goes.
Using his height advantage, he gets a clean look from the mid-range.
Here's Dunn. Good for the basket. Starting off 1-for-1 with that shot.
Amazing job by Dunn, positioning himself well inside and dominating the defense.
Caldwell Pope against Holiday. They set the screen. In the corner, it's Ingram. Puts it up from 15. Doesn't get it to drop for him. Now Chicago takes it the other way. Here's Mwaba, and he makes that one. Mwaba's got his second bucket tonight. Los Angeles leading by 12. Thomas dishes to Ingram. Here's Caldwell Pope. His last outing, 16 points for him. Lopez kicks to Mwaba. Count that one. Mwaba's got seven.
And they're beginning to just flat out fall apart defensively right now, especially on the interior.
And the Lakers, Greg, for a long time can rely on the lure of Los Angeles to draw top free agents. History does a lot, it seems.
Yeah, Paul George listing them on his short list shows they still have that pull, but the Lakers will be big players in free agency, I believe.
Going with an almost entirely new group. Bobby Portis is checked in for Lopez. Noah Vonleh comes in for Markkanen. Denzel Valentine, he's checked in for Justin Holiday. And it's Jaren Grant in for Dunn. Big group substitution here for the Lakers.
Serge Ibaka, he's checked in for Zubac. Bang comes in for Maurice Hartnes. Hart, he's checked in for Caldwell Pope. And Ball subbed in for Isaiah Thomas. Ibaka, the pass to Ball. Screened by Ibaka. Here's Ingram, and he's fouled pretty hard on that shot, but he's got the chance to pick up the points at the line. It goes on Noah Vonleh.
The knowledge that Ingram possesses, well aware that the D is going to hack him in these situations.
Well, whenever you watch the Bulls, you can't help but think back to their golden age. I remember those days. The 90 Bulls are arguably one of the best teams ever. Hard to argue with the greatness of those teams.
Here's Portis. 8 points for him. 7 second difference, shot and game clock. And slam dunk by Ingram.
And no one is catching Ingram in the open floor. This guy is like a rocket.
Grant with the ball. Now guarded by Ball. Grant dishes to Vonleh. Back to Grant. And some nice ball movement here by Chicago. The shot by Vonleh, no good. They push it up, 4-on-3. Here's Ibaka, and Ibaka slams it in.
Rugged finish by Terry. Takes the hit and burst through it for a potential and one.
And this is his first trip to the line tonight.
Yeah, he's at 81% from the line, and when we've had a chance to see him, he's had great form and continues to look confident.
And so it's Los Angeles.
The 2K Sports Halftime Show.
Hello again, everybody, along with Kenny the Jet Smith and Shaquille O'Neal. I'm Ernie Johnson. Time for the NBA Halftime Show on 2K Sports. It's the Lakers out on top at halftime. They are in control of this game, up by 18. Kenny, what's your take?
In terms of their offensive performance, that was a very well-played half of basketball. Good ball movement off the ball, hard screens being set, and they found the guy for the open look. That's how they were able to shoot such a tremendous percentage from the field. With that fluid, efficient offense, they'll be tough to catch in the second half.
How about you, Shaq? What did you think about Chicago?
Well, they struggle in a number of areas. Protecting the rim is really at the top of the list. They haven't made that a priority. They haven't put forth a whole lot of effort. You got to protect the rim.
That'll do it for now. The second half of action coming right up.
Welcome you back. We begin our second half. So far, not a tightly contested game, guys, but you know what? Lakers leading by 18. Markkanen and Lopez are together down low. Then there's Dunn. Then there's Valentine. And it's Mwaba in at the two. So that's the five in the game for Chicago.
And that's a nice jumper by Ibaka, showing good touch from mid-range.
Dunn kicks to Lopez. And Lopez throws it down.
Textbook. Nice pass. Great catch. Even better finish.
LA's gone 6 of 10 from three-point range, up over 50% for the ball game. That's going to be out of bounds. Los Angeles will retain possession. Here's Zubac.
Lopez can be such a thorn in your side with his defensive presence.
Valentine kicks to Dunn, and he banks in the layup. Dunn's got 5 points.
You get a chance to see the elite court vision there. Excellent pass.
Thomas with the ball. 9 points in the game so far. Stolen by Markkanen. Here in this third quarter, just over a minute play. Great pass to set up the lay-in. He's got 10.
The plan of attack is obvious. Get the ball inside and go strong to the rim.
Outside Thomas. He kicks to Ibaka. The three-pointer's off the mark. Bulls trail by 14. Just over a minute and a half had passed here in the third quarter. Markkanen kicks to Lopez. Feeds it to Markkanen. Five on the clock. Back to Lopez. And he drops in the layup off the glass. Lopez has got 4 points in the quarter.
Yeah, they're going to have a nice little run here.
Lakers leading by 12.
Robin Lopez, a player who does more for a team than what shows up on the stat sheet. Very effective inside with his ability to contest and fight for rebounds. A tough defender that doesn't need many touches to play his role.
And Valentine gets it to go on the assist by Lopez.
And the crisp passing has opened things up for them offensively.
It's Ingram on the wing. Pass to Zubats. Back to Ingram. Shot to end this cold run. That one off the back iron and out. And as tough as Robin Lopez is on opponents, he might be even tougher on mascots. Steve, he has a long-standing feud with mascots since he entered the NBA.
Yeah, I've seen him beat, trip, smack, and all-out abuse mascots around this league. He does it all in good and in a fun way, and fans love him for it. Everyone has to have their thing, and his fighting guys in Amazon.
Done with it. It's Ibaka picking him up. Valentine setting the pick for Markkanen. Now, here's Dunn. Not a lot of room.
All of a sudden, the shots now falling in bunches. The complexion of this game has completely changed.
Yeah, reason why they have found their shooting stroke. Their offense is clicking.
And the Lakers call time here. More demand, Steve, than right now. Do you think we're seeing more versatile players in the league now than ever before?
Yeah, we are. I mean, I think top of the list is you start off with LeBron James. Then you have players like now, Russell Westbrook, guys being able to collect triple doubles. Giannis, the Greek freak, is unbelievable because I think it's by the end of his career, he'll be able to play the five far size and one because of his skill set. Versatility in this league is a premium right now.
Now the Bulls with it. A 12-0 run right now in counting. Grant the pass to Portis. Down low. And the dunk by Vonleh.
And when they desperately needed to get things turned around, they were able to rally and get back into it.
This was all sparked by their defense. They got some stops, and they did it in a hurry.
There's the screen. And Ibaka kicks the ball. Screen by Ibaka. Here's Miles. That's it.
And how about Markkanen using his size and reach on defense? Great timing in terms of being able to get up and block shots.
The Lakers have made 4 free throws from the line and missed 2. And the Lakers, Greg, have acquired some intriguing young talent. Do you see this group blossoming into elite status?
I mean, there's still some question marks. Injuries have been an issue. I do see some all-star potential for some of their young fellas. Superstar potential, though, a little tougher to say. They've got something to build on, though, and that's key.
Hart to pass the ball. Back to right side. He gets that one. Ibaka's got 4 this quarter.
And when they've gone to him, he has come through big time. You gotta keep getting him touches.
And here is Grant. Quiet so far offensively, searching for his first points of the game. And to look now at the 4 areas where shots can come from. The paint, mid-range, and shots from deep, all broken down for Chicago.
And clearly, this is a squad that makes its living in the paint. Very few teams are as determined to get the ball inside as much as they are. They aren't going to settle for jump shots. They're going to continue to pound it down low.
Los Angeles making a switch here. Bangs checked in. Loses his man off the screen and lays it up and in.
Really, the defense is helpless to stop a layup right there. Just too much of an advantage in terms of the mismatch.
Now Grant, the dunk and the foul, a powerhouse move, and he's got a chance for one more at the line. They get through all day.
Now flying high and throwing it down with the one-hander.
One of his favorite moves right there, guys. 2-for-1 opportunity here if they want it.
And no doubt, Kevin, if I'm them, I go for it.
Here's Bowman. He's covered by Grant. It's rebounded by Vaughn.
You know, with that much room, you don't lay it up. You throw it down like you've been disrespected.
There's 21 seconds left in the third quarter.
A nice job of converting, but what really makes this play, the lead pass.
Lakers leading by three.
And when you can't hold for the last possession, that's what you want to try and do. Patience and execution. You need both here. We'll see what they run.
There's a good screen in the corner. Miles with it. Trains it from beyond the arc. Miles has got himself going with the triple, his first basket of the game.
And you have to have an appreciation for ball passing skills. I mean, he just sees the floor beautifully, easily working the ball over to open teammates.
And so it's Los Angeles, with their lead standing at 6 points here at the end of the quarter. Their lead is where it is because they've gotten good shots. A lot of good shots. We'll take a quick break and then back to the action here. All right, we welcome you back to what's been a hard-fought battle. Fourth quarter should be good. Bulls trail by six. Taking a look at the Lakers. We've got Mo Harkless all out there with Hart. Then it's Dang, and it's Kuzma in at the five. It's good. Conley's got the first basket as we get going in the fourth for Chicago.
They're finding lanes to the hoop now with consistency. Five buckets in a row from the paint.
Dang makes it off the glass.
And defensively, neither side able to get many stops. Well, this is when you need them. Late in the game. It's not all about scoring.
The dish to Vonleh. Here's Portis. And Harkless pulls it down.
No one to blame on that one but himself. You get looks like that, you've got to take it there.
Bulls have gone 1 of 3 from the field to start the fourth quarter. Inside. And he makes it look easy, dunking it hard with one hand.
And he's an automatic finisher when he gets into that area.
He is, and he picks the simple one-hand stop to get the 2 points. Pass to Kuzma. It's all in by the Bulls. Portis has got 3 rebounds so far in the game. To the paint, there's Vonleh. And he's fouled pretty hard on that shot, but he's got the chance to pick up the points at the line.
Oh, the officials are
on
it. Even though they're down, they are putting on a show.
Two shots
at the free throw line.
Chicago making some changes. Lopez, he's checked in for Jaren Grant. Denzel Valentine comes in for Markkanen. And David Mwaba subbed in for Justin Holliday. Here's the screen. Kuzma passes to Caldwell Pope. Six to shoot. There's the triple. Kuzma can't get it to go. Chicago trailing here. Valentine kicks to Lopez. That ties the game.
Well, we've seen that movie a few times, haven't we? An easy bucket in the paint.
Los Angeles has gone downtown 13 times in this game, and they're just over 50%, 7 of 13 on threes. Thomas, an open look, a three-pointer is right on target, and the Lakers lead by three.
And those aren't the type of three-point opportunities that you can allow in the NBA.
Conley kicks to Lopez, and he gets that one to go off the front iron. Lopez has got 4 points in the quarter.
Ever since halftime, he's had his eyes on the basket and just crushing it right now.
Thomas dishes to Ingram. Outside Thomas. And it's sent back by Lopez.
And that is the length of Robin Lopez on display.
We're in the final quarter of play here, 3 minutes in. In the corner, Valentine with it. Lopez a screen to take the lead. Valentine shot good.
You don't see that play regularly from them, but it led to a made three, so you can't knock them for trying it.
The Lakers trail. Caldwell Pope outside. Here's Kuzma. The pass to Zubac. Valentine grabs the board. Fourth quarter play, and over 3.5 minutes have gone by. Lopez, no luck.
Great position down low. He had more time to get that shot off than I think he realized. See, that's a solid effort on the defensive glass. You need guys who are willing to work, willing to get their hands dirty inside.
There's the pick. To the inside. It's deflected. Ingram with the steal. To the paint. That's good for Thomas on the assist from Ingram. Ingram's got his third assist on the night. Now, here's Bundley to the middle. And the jump by Lopez.
Not who you pick to come up with a huge shot, but nevertheless, Robin Lopez just delivered a huge shot for his team.
For Los Angeles, they've gotten only 3 of their 9 field goal attempts to go down since the end of the third. Pretty cold down the stretch. Here's Thomas. It's deflected. Lopez with the ball. Now it's a 4-point Bulls lead.
And that soft touch of Lopez makes things easy for him down there.
Los Angeles has gone 1-3 from outside the arc since we've reached the fourth quarter. He set the pick. Caldwell Pope gets to Ingram. Spiked away. And here we go. The Bulls. Basket counts and one. They'll go to the line with a chance to make a 3-point play.
And that couldn't have gone better for them right there. Forget about playing it safe. They're looking to finish this thing off in style.
Here's what Chicago's going with right now. Markkanen, he's checked in for Portis, and it's done in for Vonley. And the Lakers also making a switch. Bacchus checked in. It's good! And now they trail by just 4.
And this is where Ibaka's steely demeanor serves him well. No hesitation under pressure. Ooh, got a little extra on that.
He does. He doesn't usually finish soft either. Obviously, he can when necessary, but not that time. Los Angeles calls timeout. They're down by 6. 46 seconds left to play in the final quarter. Now we get a chance to check out our Jordan player of the game.
Yeah, and his percentage from the field tonight, just amazing. He hadn't just been gunning. He's been picking his shots. And you need that kind of patience and discipline to shoot as well as he has.
And we've got an update here, so let's check in with David Aldridge reporting from the sideline.
Kevin, I listened in on what Luke Walton said to his team. Yes, they're behind right now, but he's still upbeat. He said, guys, we can get back in this game. Stay together out there. All-out effort can win this game.
Here's Lopez. Oh, good on the triple. Here are the Lakers with the ball.
And this is not a time to be patient with the basketball. Yeah, for sure. They need a quick score and a foul just to have a chance.
Gets the first. That brings them within 5. Both free throws good from Isaiah Thomas. 23 seconds left in the fourth quarter. And here we go.
And always a smooth athlete. KCP doing a better job of drawing contact.
So the first one drops, and that narrows the lead down to just 3. Caldwell Pope drops them both.
And that makes it a one-possession game, guys. Got to be the biggest free throws of the game thus far.
And so they choose to intentionally foul.
Had to foul, and on that occasion, to stop the clock. That's the enemy in this situation.
Good on the first, and that makes it a 3-point lead.
And for a center, Robin Lopez is definitely one of the better free throw shooters in the league.
And he hits both free throws here. So now it's a 4-point ball game.
Nice job extending the lead and making this a 2-possession game now.
And the Lakers fall down here. They trail by 4. 16 seconds left to play in the final quarter. What's your take, guys?
I mean, tough position, but really, they can't blame anybody but themselves.
They've certainly missed on some opportunities. But stranger things have happened. They need a quick shot and an immediate foul right here.
And they need to stop the clock so there's a foul. He drops the first one, and that puts them up by five.
And Dunn does a little bit of everything out there. Scores the ball, distributes it well, and also pounds the glass aggressively.
Ingram passes to Thomas. No good from outside. And so it's Chicago winning this one. It was up for grabs right until the final seconds.
Yeah, and for me, Kevin, what stood out is just the overall trust this group has in one another when it matters most. Doing what had to be done and to send these fans home happy.
And that'll do it, folks. For Steve Smith, Greg Anthony, and David Aldridge, this is Kevin Harlan thanking you for being with us. We'll see you later.